dielectric substances and their polarization. So non-conducting materials, they are called dielectric. Non-conducting materials are known as dielectric. So Faraday, he found out that when a dielectric is introduced between the plates of a capacitor, the capacitance of the capacitor is increased. So how does this happen? We ought to know certain effects produced when a dielectric is placed in electric field. So dielectric materials, there are two types, polar and non-polar, two, polar and non-polar. The dielectric is called the polar dielectric if the molecules it possesses a permanent dipole moment, for example HCl, H plus C minus L minus H2O, like this. If the molecules of the dielectric do not possess a permanent dipole or dipole moment, which is P, then the dielectric is called the non-polar dielectric in the case of H2, O2, CO2, like this. Non-polar molecule. So in a non-polar molecule, the center of the positive charge and center of negative charge, they coincide with each other. See, in this case, this is a, we'll see the polarization of non-polar molecule. But a non-polar molecule, in non-polar molecule, the center of the positive charge and the negative charge, they coincide. So they do not possess a permanent dipole moment. They don't have it. When it is placed in, say, some uniform electric field, say E0. So now we have, this is subjected to electric field E0. Their centers are displaced in mutually opposite direction, because plus will go this side, negative will go this side. This is the property. Now they have a dipole moment, which is P, and P is equal to what? Q into the distance of separation between them. So dipole moment will be Q into D. The Q is the charges and D is the distance between them. Because of this electric field, they are separated now. An electric dipole is now induced because of the electric field. Or you can say, due to external electric field, a dielectric made of these molecules is now being polarized, because different poles are being formed, different charges are being formed. So if the electric or external electric field E0 is not very strong, it's not so strong, it is found that the dipole moment of molecule is proportional to the E0. So P is equal to alpha E0. Alpha is called the polarizability of the molecule, right? So the unit of alpha will be P by E0, that is because of P dipole moment and electric field, it will be C square M by N. Polar molecule. So the polar molecule, they possess a permanent dipole moment P. So they have a charge minus Q, say plus Q, and they are separated by certain distance. But these dipole moments of different molecules or substance, they are randomly oriented in all the possible directions. So the resultant dipole moment will be essentially zero. If we apply electric field, there will be a torque. Torque will act on every molecular dipole. So it rotates and it will try to become parallel to the electric field. So if the dipole is like this, electric field is like this, it will get a torque and this will now become aligned to the electric field. So a resultant dipole moment will be produced. In this way, the dielectric made up of such molecule is said to be now polarized. And due to thermal collisions, the dipole moment also gets deviated from being parallel to electric field, because there will be oscillations. If the temperature is T, the dipole will be arranged in such an equilibrium condition that the average thermal energy per molecule, which is 3/2 kBT, this kb is Boltzmann constant, it balances the potential energy of the dipole, which is minus P dot E in the electric field. But at zero Kelvin, the temperature, that this, since the thermal energy is zero, the dipole become parallel to the electric field, right? When there is air or vacuum between charge plates, so this is one plate, this is second plate. If there is vacuum or air between these charge plates of capacitor, The electric field between the plate will be given by E0 sigma F by epsilon naught. So what is this sigma F? This is the value, sigma F is the value of surface charge density of each plate. So the charge on these plate is called the free charge. Why? Because its value can be adjusted at our will. We can join any proper battery. So the area of each plate, let us say it as A. Now on placing a slab of dielectric material, say polar or non-polar, in the region between these plates, here, in between them, the polarization produced by the electric field, which is say E0, we want to find out the electric field inside this dielectric. What is the electric field inside this dielectric? We are interested in this. So from this figure, it is very clear that the opposite charge in the successive dipoles, say this one or this one or this one, inside this slab will cancel the effect of each other, as you see here. As they are very close to each other, and the net or resultant charge reside only on the faces of this slab, which is very close to the plate. So this one and this one, others will be nullified. So these charges are called induced charges, or you can say, because they are at boundary, they are called bound charges, or you can say polarization charges. So the charge induced on the surface of the slab close to the positive plate, that means this plate, is minus sigma B, we are saying it as B into A, and here the charge induced close to this negative one, negative plate, is plus sigma B into A. This sigma B and sigma B minus and minus plus sigma B, these are the surface density of bound charges on the respective surfaces. So this induced charges form a dipole now. So its dipole moment will be what? We can say that dipole moment for total one is sigma into A into D, the distance between them. So there is a distance D between them. So sigma A into sigma, this is the charge. We know that Q is given by sigma into A, because sigma was Q into A. So this Q is sigma A and D multiplied. So we get the dipole moment. D is the thickness of the slab, that is the distance between the two plates. If the side of the slab touch the plate, A into D is, if you multiply A and D, you get the volume. So we can say that this is nothing but volume. So now the dipole moment, which is produced per unit volume, which is called as the intensity of polarization, or we can just say polarization. So polarization is dipole, total dipole divided by volume. So we can divide this by A into D, that is the volume. You get only sigma. So the magnitude of polarization in a dielectric is equal to nothing but the surface density of bound charges. That is why we have B subscript induced in this surface. So the electric field produced by these induced charges is in the direction which is opposite to the electric field. If electric field is like this, it is in the opposite direction. So the resultant electric field inside the dielectric here can be considered as produced by what? Sigma F minus sigma B, right? So sigma F minus sigma B by epsilon naught is the electric field. So the net electric field inside the dielectric is actually less. See, it is less than the applied electric field. But just recall that the net electric field in the conductor was zero. And also, it is found that if the electric field or external electric field E0 is not very strong, then the polarization P is directly proportional to the net electric field. We are saying that this P is directly proportional to E. Polarization is proportional to the net electric field inside the dielectric. And when we remove this this sign proportionality, we get P equal to epsilon naught 0 and XE into E. X is nothing but a constant, which is called the electric susceptibility of the dielectric medium. So it depends on the nature of the dielectric and the temperature. So dielectric, this obeying P is directly proportional to E. Whichever dielectric observe this pattern is called a linear dielectric. So XE become, if we take XE on one side, it will be P by epsilon naught E. this E0 was sigma F by epsilon naught, and P was equal to sigma B, we just found out. So now this E becomes, we will just replace these values. Epsilon naught E0 minus P by epsilon E0, let us rearrange them by putting this P as this value. So when we rearrange, we get this as the permittivity. This is called the permittivity of the dielectric medium. So epsilon is nothing but because ultimately this cancels out, and E, this epsilon is equal to epsilon naught 1 plus XE. So we are saying that we can put this as epsilon. So this is epsilon. We'll put epsilon here for this. So E epsilon is equal to E0 epsilon 0. So E becomes epsilon 0 by epsilon by epsilon 0. But we know that epsilon by epsilon 0 is the relative permeability or permittivity. Relative permittivity ER of the medium. And this is nothing but the K, which is the dielectric constant of the medium. The value K will always be greater than 1. So we say E epsilon by epsilon 0 or epsilon R is K. Now, because of this equation and because of this equation, when you combine them, we get K equal to 1 plus XE. So this is showing that the relationship between the electric properties XE and K of the dielectric, right? Now, this equation now can be rewritten. E will be equal to E0 by this will be K. So E will be E0 by K. So the electric field in a certain region in the free space is epsilon 0. When a dielectric is placed in the region, some dielectric is placed in the region, the electric field in the dielectric will be kth part, that is, it will be divided by 1 by k times the value in the free space. Electric displacement. So when a dielectric is placed between the plates of a capacitor, see, same thing we are going, the net electric field produced in the electric or dielectric is given by this expression we have just found out. Sigma F was what? The value of surface density of free charges. And this sigma B was what? The value of surface density of bound charges. B for bound. Now, since this sigma bound is P, equal to P only, polarization value, this E becomes sigma F minus P by epsilon naught. Just rearrange them, you get this expression. The direction of this electric field and this P will be same. So this, if you take it as a vector form, this is called the dielectric displacement, or you can say as D. So you can write D as epsilon naught E plus P. So it is a vector field, and if you use the direction definition of D, various equation regarding electric field will become more simpler. So Gauss theorem in the presence of dielectric will be given by, this is Gauss surface, D dot ds will be equal to Q. Q is the only the free charge. Bound charge we are not including. So in case of dielectric, the field related to the free charge is not this one, but it will be this one, D, right? That means we are going to use this value here. So for dielectric, we have to use D in place of E.